sits right now, it's 1.6 million. And it doesn't have up. I mean, it does have the slat on it, but it's on it right now. It's depleting uranium. It'll stop 7.62 on the 7.62. It's an 8-wheel drive, independent axles. You can either put in the 4x4 or 8x8. Has a 350 twin turbo Caterpillar diesel engine in it. It goes 70 miles per hour. You can get them up a little faster, but they put the valve handle in your rear chase side, so they don't go crazy. Weighs 22 tons the way it sits. 53 gallons worth of diesel. Getting around roughly 350 in the tank. You can blow out six of the wheels. Still drive this all the wheels are self-inflated. Has its own air compressor system built into it. The whole system is on a kind of like on an air ride system, best way to describe it. It can actually drop itself down 6 inches from the secondary mount. The reason they designed it that way is the C7 Galaxies with some Air Force plane. We can actually drop it down back 2 inches into it, and it can actually pick off of them. That's why they do it. But for when we're actually going to deploy and stuff, we actually railhead them down to Texas. They get put on a boat, and they get sent to whatever port we got to.
That's a
team's up and operational and like in country, and they actually have been doing it for quite some time. I could give them a call for fire mission, and they could be lobbing rounds anywhere from 5 to 7 minutes from even when they're driving. From a dead stop, and 5 minutes later, the rounds are coming. There's 7 different variants of this vehicle. 2 of them are here. This is the mortar, and then the infantry carrier's over there. That one's a little bit more funner. It's you can mount a 50 caliber Mark 19 onto it. It has a remote weapon system. It's all joystick controlled. Has built-in thermal, range finder, everything built into it. You can kick on the thermal too. I always like it when the kids do it, because then they can actually see what it looks like at nighttime. You can look at all the vehicles too and see which one's been raining in a while, because you can see the heat coming off of it. But yeah, like the computer system that's on the mortar tube right now will say, that's where I'll get my instructions for either, you know, which degrees, turn it left, turn it right. This is my elevation based off what the computer will set. And then once I get it locked in, you just call up your front saying, hey, coordinates locked. He'll verify the coordinates, I verify my coordinates back, and then I drop the rocks.
Wait, so this will come up?
No, that stays right there. And the reason it's there is you can actually flip that up, or you can leave it down. But it's for a guy would actually stand there, like the ammo bearer stands there, and he just grabs the rounds out of the trays right there. They're locked in right now, but
go in here.
Yeah, literally a guy would stand right there, grab the rounds out, and just drop them right in the tube. But 2 summers ago, they shot 10 mortar vehicles like this, went through, it was a 24-hour fire, and it was almost 7,000 rounds. They shot out of 10 vehicles. It was a continuous fire. Basically, if you wanted to drop some rounds, go out and drop some rounds, because the guys can only, you can only lift so many of them before you start getting, getting tired. Yeah. So like, if anybody wants to go fire some more, just go out and drop a couple, hang a couple rounds.
Will this come down here?
That's as low as it goes. It actually raises up. I'll give you what you're doing is see how it spins just by adjusting it. And then this one actually does your elevation. I got it locked in because kids come in here and adjust everything. But
some triangles like this. No.
This whole thing angles up, and then you adjust it wherever you want it to go.
Yeah,
that tube lifts the whole way up.
This one tips up, it's not that far.
Nope. And then this turns it wherever you need it to go.
Where's the base plate? Yeah.
This is the base plate.
It is the base plate.
Yep. So when, and there's like a spring under this that's built in. So when it hits, the vehicle won't even shift. You won't even know.
Huh.
The spring takes a lot of the tension. This whole thing will just drop down. The spring will take the whole hit and come up. Yeah, things have come a long way. 10 different settings for it. There's actually a round, it's called a, basically, it's an easy way to describe it. It's a round like that, but it's all shotgun shells. Think about a big shotgun shell you're gonna fire. I could blow a hole right through a wall if I wanted to. I could take down the wall. I could do a single shot sabo and fire it right through the wall and actually go inside the building. But we don't bring that. The state only has like four of them because
right.
they're very expensive.
Is that up above the top?
Yeah, it looks like a tank.
Right.
But yeah, it's
just,
this could take out a tank.